Hey everyone, I'm Ryan. You're watching 60 Cycle Hum, and in this video, I'm going to completely disassemble my Harley Benton MS60 here. In the last video, I swapped out the stock bridge for a more traditional style Mustang bridge, and I've got to say, I'm really happy with the results. It made it a heck of a lot more tuning stable, and it feels really solid. I'm pretty impressed with how great this guitar feels with this Mustang bridge. So I'm gonna keep that in there. I'm gonna go from here and move into the other mods that I wanna do with this thing. First of all, I wanna put a different pickup in this thing. I've got this Fender wide range guy here that I got from Grant from Big Ear NYC. Think about just dropping it in the bridge or doing something really funky and sticking it in a weird angle in the middle or something like that. I have no idea what I want to do as far as neck pickup goes. Maybe I'll just do single humbucker. I don't know. Maybe I'll throw some sort of weird like toaster pickup in there or like a Tele pickup or something. I don't know. The sky's the limit. I can figure that out when I get to it. Also, like I've mentioned, I want to cut a brand new pickguard for this thing. I'm not a big fan of the Perloid. Someone commented on the last video, an idea that I think is really a fun thing to experiment with, is I should try to cut a pickguard with normal like hand tools instead of, you know, doing it the official way with a router, which I have. I could cut a pickguard with a router, but I really like the idea of tackling it with just simple hand-powered tools with materials that you can find around. I don't even know what I'm gonna do yet, but I wanna explore that direction. And also I'm gonna drop in an actual Mustang control plate into this guy. So that won't be part of the pickguard when I drop this in. I might even let it be pickguardless for a while. Just open cavity, just the control plate here to house the controls. I don't know. There's a lot of stuff I could do or not do with this guitar, and I'm excited to just mess around with it and have fun. So let's start pulling screws out and get this thing taken apart. I guess I should start with the strings in the neck first. Here comes the time-lapse stuff. Pickguard just comes right out here. I don't remember if I've had this pickguard off yet. A big question people have had is if these switches can be replaced with the traditional three-position Mustang switches. I don't know. I've never messed with those, but maybe taking a close look here at what's under the hood, you can figure that out for yourself. All right, so we've got just the body here. I even took the strap buttons off of it. I think something that's funny about this guitar is that the route for the tremolo was done after the paint job, when the route for the control cavity was done before. That's got to be just because they also use this body for a version that has a stop tail bridge on it. Let's see if that Mustang control plate fits correctly here. I know other people have done that mod where they have put the control plate on. I mean, it looks like it fits just fine. But I'm of course not trying to mount a traditional Mustang pickguard on here either. I can line it up to those two screw holes there, but then this screw hole kind of floats over the edge. So if I wanted this to line up with those pre-existing screw holes, I'd have to put a bit of dowel of wood right in here or something like that to give an extra place for a screw to grab onto. That's interesting. I think this will look handsome on here no matter what. Am I gonna have to route for the pickup? Let's find out. Yeah, I'm gonna have to route out wood to fit a humbucker in here of any style. There's just too much wood in the way. Single coils only. That's okay, I have a router. I have chisels, I can do that stuff. I guess using a router on this would betray the idea of cutting a pickguard without a router, but I don't care. I'm still gonna use a router on it to open that up. I'll probably just do a full swimming pool route to open that up as much as possible, maybe even open this more. There's no reason I can't do that by hand either. I don't need templates or anything. I can guide a router through there and do what I need to do. All right, I want to do some relicking now as I relic my camera by bashing it with the guitar body. I don't know how to tackle this. I kind of want it to be as random as possible. I always feel like relic jobs look really unnatural because you can tell that someone did what they think a relic should look like. They're like, oh, I'm gonna chip all the paint off on the top edge because obviously that's where paint will come off because people are using their arm on it. I don't want this to look like a 40-year-old nitro finish. I want this to look like a beat up punk rock poly finish, like this guitar was just kind of thrown across the venue every night. So I'm not going to be trying to do anything subtle or like heat cracks or anything like that, checking any of that sort of stuff. I kind of just want to throw stuff at it or like put it in a big box with random things and like shake it for a while. That sounds like fun to me. All right, I'm going to get set up to start beating this thing up, and I'll check back in with you guys. I'm not going to do different videos. It'll be the same video. I'll be right back. All right, I've got this big Rubbermaid tote here that the guitar fits in just fine. It's almost like they made this tote for guitar bodies. You can fit 5 or 6 guitar bodies in here for safe storage, you know, keep them fresh for the future. So I'm going to throw a few things in with this guy to shake around with it. I've got this like wooden screwdriver thing. I've got this old, gross, bad-looking pickup. An Allen wrench. Bunch of little adjuster rings for mic stands. Drum tuning key. A belt buckle, get that real life belt buckle rash. A couple different keychains. This one's a Levy's keychain that I got from Summernam, I think. A razor blade, just for fun. Little wing nut. Another set of keys. And then a bunch of random coins. So there's an okay amount of stuff in there. So again, I'm going for like the most random relic I can get. I'm not planning out like what looks authentic or, you know, 40 years of you know, arm pushing against the armrest of the body. I just want random dings and bumps here. So here we go. I don't know how long this is gonna take, but I have a feeling I'm gonna work up a sweat after this. Want to check on it. Oh, there's some little dings in here. Let's see if we can focus on that. A little bit of ding right there. Not much else to speak for though. Nice little ding right there. I mean, we're getting there. There's some bumps and scratches. It definitely doesn't look new anymore, but it's got a ways to go. Till I'm happy with it anyways. All right, back in the box it goes. I'm gonna put it face down this time. Whew. Oh man, I wasn't planning on having such a workout today. Ooh, now we're getting some good dings in here. on the back anyway. So there's a good ding right there, good ding right there. Let's go to the front. Still not a lot on the front. Decent, nice little nick right there. Good ding right there. It's starting to get the direction that I want. Nice little roughed up spots on the edge of the neck pocket. Yeah, it's definitely going the direction that I'm looking for here. It's just a abused guitar with like random dings and check marks in it. There's some pressure dings throughout here. It's looking good. I'm feeling happy so far. It looks aged. Nice authentic aging on this guitar. Should I throw any more stuff in the box? All right, I'm gonna throw two sinusoid sliver patch cables in there. I'm gonna throw a pancake plug that I randomly have in there. I'm gonna throw a strap spring that I have in there just to add to the chaos. Because why not? I'm getting real tired. But for some added realism, I'm gonna throw the control plate in there. Focus it in. You can see you're getting all these kinds of like light chipping and stuff on the edges here that I really like. Interesting, getting a lot of good chips here in the body cavity. Really good chipping on the back. It's coming right along. I feel like that's a good like natural punk rock relic. The sort of thing I was going for. Anyways, there's some grime on here. Good chip right up here in the neck pocket. I think I'm happy. I think I might try a couple other fun little things and then I'll call it a day for the relic. All right, so now I've got this idea that I got hanging up. I'm gonna whip it with the end of this belt here. Old school capital punishment style here, I guess. All right, let's see if this does anything. Certainly are quite a few scuffs and pressure indents on here now. I'll give it a few more whips and then I'm gonna move on to something else. Well, if I've reliced anything, I definitely reliced my belt buckle quite a bit here. Not the buckle, but the belt itself. This is an old belt, so it's fine. Well, I feel like I really did what I set out to do. I achieved a pretty nice, like, dirty punk rock, natural sort of relic on this guitar. It looks like it's been loved by teenagers more than it should have. Some nice dings and scratches on the back and stuff. I don't know if any of that's in focus right now. Sometimes it's hard to tell. But anyways, the next thing, last thing I wanted to do is attack it with some steel wool to try to take the shine off a little bit, try to get more of a matte finish out of it. Ah, left-handed scissors, I always forget. And you're a lefty forced to learn how to use right-handed scissors because you don't have any lefties for your entire life. Picking up a pair of left-handed scissors can feel a little foreign, a little confusing, but then they actually work when you use them, which is nice. So I'm gonna tack this thing with some steel wool, and then we'll get out of here, and the next time I make a video, I'll be cutting a pickguard, I guess. I think the trick with this is to follow the motion that like a picking hand would make, because that's the kind of scratches it's leaving. Like years and years of pick scrapes and, you know, clothing rubbing on the finish and whatnot. I can probably get more random with it in the arm area. Random directions, but around here, really want that just single direction. All right, I've made a big ol' dusty mess of myself now. I think it looks good. I'll put some close-up pictures of it so you can see kind of the finer details of the damage here. I'm looking forward to cutting a pickguard and getting this thing playable. I think it looks pretty cool now. I mean, it looked cool before, but you know, I'm not like a huge relic guy. But I get it. I think a nice bit of natural looking wear on a guitar is a fun look. I have the opinion that, you know, guitars are more than just instruments. They're also stage props in a lot of ways. And if you can communicate certain things to your audience with the look of your guitar, then there's no shame in that. I mean, I'm sure there's already a debate going on in the comment section down below about people saying, oh, you gotta earn your dings and stuff like this, and this is all relics, all these fake relics, blah blah blah, in my day, all that sort of stuff. But I don't know. I'm open to all sorts of looks and ideas as far as guitars go. Anyways, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, dislike, leave me rude, nasty comments. You know the whole drill. Support us on Patreon and stay grounded. Bye, everybody.